Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, let's do a proof to verify this identity that you see here. So one way of verifying an identity is you start with one side and you manipulate it using other identities and arithmetic and algebra until it looks like the other side of the equation. So I'm going to use that method here. So let's say I'm going to do a proof beginning with the left-hand side because this looks more complicated. I think I could take this and make it look like that. Personally, I think it's going to be easier to just use the formulas for the cosine of a sum and the sine of a difference. So I'm going to start out with cosine of a plus b over the sine of a minus b, and I'm going to use those identities to get started. So I'm going to have the cosine of a plus b is cosine of a, cosine of b minus sine of a, sine of b. And in the denominator, we've got the sine of a minus b, that'll be the sine of a, cosine of b minus the cosine of a, sine of b. Now, nothing cancels here. Be careful. Unless it's completely factored, you can't cancel anything. So don't try canceling out this sine b over sine b or the cosine b over cosine b. Don't look at this cosine a over sine a and think you've got a cotangent of a. No, not going to work. All right, so this is what we've got so far, and we're always keeping in mind what are we trying to get to. So I'm looking up here at the top right. I'm trying to get 1 minus tangent a tangent of b. So I'm actually have something that looks close in a way to what I have up here because look at I've got two terms with a minus sign in the numerator, just like I have here. And in the denominator, I have two terms with a subtraction sign. So, I wonder if there's some way of manipulating this to get it to look like that. So, the first thing I notice is, see, I have this cosine A, cosine B. It's supposed to be a 1, right? Is there something I could do to make that look like a 1? And if so, algebraically, what could I do to the whole fraction? Well, if I divide it by cosine A cosine B, then I would have a 1 here. But of course, you can't just divide one part. You have to take a fraction and multiply or divide the whole numerator and the whole denominator by the same thing, or divide the whole numerator and denominator by the same thing. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide the whole numerator by cosine A cosine B. And when I do this, I'm going to show it by separating it out. So instead of writing the whole thing over cosine A cosine B, I'm going to put each of these terms over cosine A cosine B. So I have cosine A cosine B over something, and then I'm going to do the sine A sine B over something. And in the denominator, I'm going to have to do the same thing. Divide it by the same thing everywhere. And that thing is cosine A cosine B because I know that at least I'll get a 1 there. Now, if I do this and it doesn't work out, that means okay, I tried something and it didn't work out. But let's just see what does happen when I do it. So I'm dividing each term in the numerator and denominator by cosine A cosine B. So what does that give me? Well, now that cancels and that cancels, right? So that's going to be a 1. So in the numerator, I'm going to have a 1 for this first term minus what happens over here. Does anything cancel? No. But hopefully you see I've got a sine A over a cosine A, and I have a sine B over a cosine B, and a sine over cosine is going to give you the tangent of A. Awesome, that's what we wanted. I wanted a tangent of A. And the sine B over cosine B gives me the tangent of B. And then let's see what happens in the denominator. The cosine b's cancel out, and I've got a sine a over cosine a, which, awesome, is tangent of a minus. These cosines cancels, and I have sine b over cosine b, which is tangent of b. So I was able to prove it. And if you want, you can put it at the end. QED means that which was to be proved. Just shows that you finished the problem. And so there we are with another trig proof. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.